Come on in, get the bell.
Valentine will answer it.
Oh, it's probably Margaret.
No. She's not due back till 10:30. And it's not even 10 o'clock.
Ah, oh, Mademoiselle Duchette.
Oh, Marguerite's not here.
No, did you want to see her?
Yes, I was just passing by and thought I would give her a little hug.
Wait a while, she'll be back soon.
I can't stay. Gustav is waiting for me downstairs. Nanine, how is she feeling?
Still the same.
Tell her I'll be by to see her soon. Goodbye, Nanine. Good night, sir.
Goodbye!
Wow, who was that?
That was Mademoiselle Nichette.
Nichette sounds like a name for a cat, not for a young lady.
Nichette is a nickname. Did you see the way her hair curls on the top of her head like a little kitten?
Uh-huh.
Friends at work gave it to her because she looks like a cat. Nichette worked in the same shop as Marguerite.
What? Marguerite worked in a shop?
Yes.
Mind you, Marguerite worked
so
in a shop?
Saucy lingerie.
She's pretty.
And very respectable.
Who's that Gustav character?
Which Gustav?
The Gustav that was waiting downstairs.
Oh, that's her husband.
Oh, so it is Madame Nichette.
Well, he's not her husband yet, but he will be. Mademoiselle Nichette is very respectable.
Well, well, well.
That's Marguerite. Do you want me to repeat the slanders I've been hearing?
Watch out.
Go tell them we need supper. Olympia Saint-Gaudens are coming, and I ran into him at the opera.
Oh, you here?
Will it be my fate always waiting for you?
And is it my destiny to never come home without finding you here?
Until you lock me out, I keep coming.
Well, what is it you have to say?
You know very well.
Always the same thing. You're very monotonous, Baron Barville.
Is it my fault I love you?
If I allowed myself to listen to all those who love me, I'd never have time for dinner.
Please.
If you're going to continue talking about your love, I'll have to send you home.
Last year at Bagnères gave me some hope.
But that was at Bagnères, where I was ill and so bored.
What?
This is Paris, and I'm much better, and hardly.
Now that Duke de Marin dotes on you?
Idiot.
And in love with that count?
I'm free to love whoever I choose. It concerns no one but me, and least of all you. So, if you haven't anything better to say, just go. Aren't you leaving?
No.
Then sit down. Your pacing's annoying.
Look, Margaret, I have 80,000 francs a year.
How nice! I have 100,000. Have you seen Prudence?
Yes.
Is she coming this evening?
Yes, and Nichette dropped by.
Isn't she sweet?
And the doctor came earlier.
What did he say?
He recommends that you rest.
The good doctor. Is that all?
And this bouquet came.
Roses and lilacs. Take these flowers to your room, Nanny.
Marguerite, don't you like those flowers?
What do they call me?
Marguerite Gaudier.
And what other name have they given me?
Oh, the Lady of the Camellias.
Why?
Because you don't like any other flower.
That's true. I don't care for any other flowers.
I'm not having much luck today. Goodbye, Marguerite.
Goodbye, my poor Baron.
Visitors, Marguerite!
Olympia, at last, I thought you weren't coming.
You can blame Saint-Gaudens. It's all his fault.
It's always my fault. Evening, Barker.
Good evening.
Are you having supper here?
No, he is not.
Then how are you, my dear?
Quite well.
You are looking very much better. We are going to have a great time.
It's always fun where you are, Marguerite.
Shame on you. naughty girl, but what about poor, dear Varville, who's going without supper? So sad.
Why didn't you invite Edmund?
Why didn't you bring him?
With Saint-Gaudens?
Isn't he used to it?
Not yet, my dear. You see, it's so difficult for someone his age to acquire new habits, especially good ones.
Supper should be ready.
Just 5 minutes.
Haven't you gone, Baron?
I'm just leaving.
Who is this Prudence?
My neighbor. She makes hats.
And I'm the only one that buys them. But I like her. And she doesn't have any money. It's chilly this evening. Varville, put some wood on the fire. It's freezing in here.
What?
Well, make yourself useful if you can't be agreeable.
Madame de Vinoy and her two gentlemen, Gaston Rieu and Armand Duval.
What style? People get announced here.
I dress quite well, madame.
Well, we needn't be quite so formal. Marguerite, I would like for you to meet Armand Duval. Poor fellow is more in love with you than anyone in Paris. My, what does one say to one who's more in love with me than anyone else in Paris? Don't I need to put two more places for dinner? I hope his great passion hasn't destroyed his appetite.
Gaston, I am delighted to see you.
Saint-Gaudens, as young as ever.
Much younger.
And are all your love affairs prospering?
As you can see.
Congratulations.
I was afraid we'd find Germaine here.
No, poor Germaine. She was so fond of you.
Too fond, but there was a certain young gentleman she would not get rid of.
Oh.
Her banker. Certainly, he was no match for me. She loved me for myself, but there was a great deal of hiding in closets, roaming around on the stairs, and waiting in the street.
Which brought on that rheumatism.
Not at all. Things change. None of us grow younger. But poor Baron, no supper.
Isn't he wonderful?
It's only the old that grow no older.
Sir. Aren't
you
related to Monsieur Duval, the receiver general for our country?
Yes, sir, he is my father. Do you know him?
Met him many years ago at Mademoiselle Mercy's. Along with your beautiful and charming mother.
My mother died 3 years ago.
Forgive me. Oh,
it's quite all right. It's always an honor to hear about my mother.
Are you an only child?
I have one sister. She is to be married.
I think your friend is charming.
He is. And what's more, he just adores you. Doesn't he, Prudence? Prudence?
What?
I was telling Margaret that Armand is madly in love with her.
Oh, no doubt about it.
He loves you so much that he doesn't even try telling you.
He's loved you for 2 years. Long story then. Poor Armand, he spends all his days at Gustave's and Nichette's just to hear them talking about you.
Do you remember last year when you were ill? There was a young man who came to inquire about you every day for 3 solid months.
But he wouldn't leave his name, I remember.
That was Armand.
How nice of him. Armand?
Yes?
Do you know what I've just been hearing? That you came to ask about me every day when I was ill.
It's quite true, madame.
Well, the least I can do is to thank you. Did you hear that, Varville? You never did that for me, did you?
Oh, I haven't known you only for a year.
Don't be silly. This young gentleman's only known me 5 minutes.
Dinner!
And when shall we see you again?
Whenever you wish.
Goodbye, then.
Gentlemen.
Farewell, Orville.
Marguerite, you really are a little too hard on the old Baron. Well, he bores me with his 80,000 francs.
Imagine complaining about that. Wish somebody would offer to leave me.
I like that.
Come along, Troy. Help yourselves, but don't quarrel. And what do I smell?
Must be those partridges.
Herr Baron.
How late you are.
You mean to opera.
Armand. It was a mistake to come here.
Not at all. You'd had to face him sooner or later.
Have you been speaking to him?
Yes.
About me?
Yes.
Well, what did he say?
That he holds no ill will toward you and that you were quite right.
So much the better if it's so, but I doubt it is.
Armand is here.
I know.
Do you swear to me that you didn't know he were to be here?
I swear.
Promise me that you won't speak to him.
I promise, but I can't promise not to answer if he could speak to me. Prudence, stay beside me.
Good evening, Marguerite.
Augusto. So good to see you. Is Michette with you?
No.
Of course. Give her my love.
What is the matter?
Nothing. I'm just very unhappy.
No problem. Why'd you come here?
I just lost control of my life.
If you take my advice, you'll go away from here at once.
Why?
Because you never know what might happen. Armand?
Armand hates me.
No, he doesn't. Armand loves you. Look at him now. How wildly he's playing. He hardly knows what he's doing. There will be some trouble between him and the Baron, perhaps a duel. Make any excuse. Say that you're ill. And leave here as soon as possible.
No. On my account. You're right. I'll go at once.
Where
are you going? I feel ill and I'm tired. I don't want to go.
No, you're not ill, Margaret. You want to go home merely because Armand Duval is here. We came here. We stay here.
What were they doing tonight at the opera?
La Favorita.
How interesting. It is a story of a woman who betrays her lover.
How unoriginal. How untrue. Women do not betray their lovers.
Some do.
Yeah, well then there are lovers, and there are lovers.
Just as there are women, and there are women.
High stakes. You're playing a reckless game tonight, Armand.
I'm trying to prove the truth of the proverb, unlucky at love, lucky at cards.
Well, you must be very unhappy in love, judging from your extraordinary luck at cards.
I intend to make my fortune tonight, my friend. And then when I am rich, I want to move out to the country.
Alone?
No. With someone who went with me once and left me. It all depends on what happens tonight. Maybe when I am wealthy.
Be quiet, Armand.
It's actually an interesting story you would all enjoy. And there's a gentleman who makes his appearance at the very end, a sort of Deus Ex Machina. A charming little fella.
Sir!
If you challenge Armand to a duel, you'll never see me again.
You address yourself to me, sir?
I did. Your luck tonight tempts me to try my wand. I understand perfectly how you propose to employ your winnings. I'll be happy to increase them for you.
Therefore, I bet against you.
Your interest in my travels is overwhelming, sir.
I stake 100 francs.
100 francs? What side do you take?
The one opposite to you.
100 francs on the left.
100 francs to the right.
Right 4, left 9, our monument.
200 francs then!
200 francs, be careful, sir. If the proverb says unlucky at love, lucky at cards, it also says lucky at cards, unlucky at love.
It looks as if the Baron will pay for Armand's visit to the country.
Shall we continue the game?
No,
supper
not
is
now.
In the next room, gentlemen.
You're entitled to your revenge, sir, and you shall have it any way you wish.
Have no fear, sir. I shall take full advantage of your offer.
Armand, you've had wonderful luck tonight.
Marguerite, are you coming?
No, I wish to speak to Prudence for a moment.
You like me much better when I am winning, don't you, Olivia?
If you don't join me in 10 minutes, I shall return here for you.
Ladies.
Prudence, send Armand to me right away.
Armand, what if he refuses?
He won't refuse. Go at once.
You sent for me?
Oh, Armand. I wish to speak to you.
Go on. I'm listening. Do you wish to excuse yourself?
No. I have no wish to go over the past again.
You're right. Your part in it was too shameful.
No, Mom. Listen to me. Try to listen without anger and hatred. And give me your hand.
Never. If you have nothing else to say to me.
Whatever thought you would refuse my hand. Armand! You must leave Paris right away.
Leave here?
Yes, immediately.
Why?
Because if you don't, the Baron will challenge you to a duel.
And you're suggesting I should run away?
Armand, for the sake of our past love, return to your father and forget you ever known me.
I see. You're afraid for your lover. It would be a pity if a pistol shot or a sword thrust were to put an end to your present good fortune.
It's you that's could be in danger. You could get killed.
And what did you care about that? Did you care about that when you wrote to me that you were the mistress of another? If that letter didn't kill me, it was only that I would live to be revenged.
The Baron has nothing to do with this.
You love him. That's reason enough for me to hate him.
You know I don't love you, and I never have.
And yet you left me and went to him. Why?
Don't ask me. I can't tell you.
I'll tell you. It's because you don't know the meaning of loyalty and honor. Because your heart belongs to the highest bidder. And your love is something that can be bought and sold. You were faced with a sacrifice, and you lacked the courage, and you went to the past. All because I wanted to devote my entire life to you, and honor too, meant less to you than all your horses and your carriages and jewels.
Then don't endanger yourself for my sake. Leave Paris before it's too late.
I will leave on one condition.
I agree to anything.
Would you come with me? Oh. I swear, there is madness in me tonight. I thought that it was hatred that was driving me back to you, but it's love. Marguerite, please say the words and we can leave Paris. What do I care for this Baron? Tell me that you love me and we will be alone where I love.
I give 1 hour for such happiness. But I can't. I've sworn it.
To whom?
To one who had the right to ask such a thing.
To the Baron?
Yes.
Tell me that you love him and I will leave here right now.
Yes, I love him.
Thank you. Marguerite Gautier. Do you know what she did for me? She gave up all that she had to live with me because she loved me so much. It was noble and generous, wasn't it? And you've all heard how vilely I treated her. But it's not too late. I know now that I was wrong, and I want to settle the account between us. I want you all to witness that I owe this woman nothing.
I thank you, sir.